Super Mario is a masterpiece of our childhood. In his video games, it has introduced a very cool pixelization effect that we can now see in many titles, like The Binding of Isaac. In this video, we are going to create it using Unity 3D. The effect is a post-process applied to the camera. It resizes the UV of the rendered image, simulating the decrease of screen resolution. We created a new standard 3D Unity project and import two screens of Super Mario. In a new scene, we kept the camera and a sprite image used as background. To apply material to the camera and use it as post-process, we created a script that implements a method called onRenderedImage. Here we use the function blip of the graphic class to copy a source texture and apply it to a new destination using a different shader. These operations can be used only in the standard graphic pipeline. If you are using a different template, like the low-way render pipeline, check the new Unity Blitz shader. Also, we added the Execute in Edit Mode decorator to see the result directly in the editor. We created a custom shader focusing on the fragment part. A fragment shader lets us make operations on each single pixel that compose our final rendered image. We declared a float variable to handle the pixel size. Basic operation of a fragment shader is to use the UV coordinates to sample the input image, in this case the entire viewport of the camera. Until we didn't assign our custom material to the camera script, we saw a black screen. Assigning it, we continued to see our original image. This was okay, because in the fragment shader we didn't make any particular operation. Returned to the shader, we calculated the new UV coordinates. We divided the x value of the UV by pixel size. To the result, we added 0.5, and at the end, we multiplied everything for pixel size. We did the same for the Y chords and used these new values as chords of the sampling. Moving pixel size creates now the pixelization effect on the final image. Last operation on the shader was to layer the sampled color with black. As wake of the interpolation, we added a new float variable that we multiplied for pixel size. Now, the more we pixelize, the more we get a black result. To animate a material that is not accessible by the mesh render component, we needed a script. A coroutine activated by space compression made the task. Here we first reach a max size to limit the dimension of the effect. Then, we swap the initial image with the second one, like if you are passing to another level of the game, and we make the same while loop at the contrary to obtain again a sharp image. To avoid material-related error, we added a function to initialize the material to the standard values. This is the final result. So, what do you think about it? Hope this will be useful for your project. Please don't forget to subscribe and comment. See you in the next video. Bye!